love our President
Thank
Trump.
Guys. Thank
yes,
you guys.
We do. USA.
USA, that was phenomenal.
It was great.
Amazing. Before illegal.
It was great.
That was one of the greatest experiences of my life. I would never forget that.
It was wonderful, man. It was beautiful. Absolutely. Look at all these Uncle Toms, right? Free thinking blacks.
It was fantastic. It was amazing.
It's such an honor to have been able to get there and even see the president in person. It was amazing.
I just met the president, man. He told me I was the flyest guy in the room. It was an honor. Thank you. You know, I didn't think I would be here, guy from the streets in the White House.
I never would think I'd be one of the first in my family to be invited to the White House as a black man. You know, not too many people can say that amongst black families. You know, so it's good that that actually happened, you know. I made history in my family.
Amazing experience, lots of regular Americans getting in there, having an opportunity to share laughs with the President of the United States. It was a great experience.
I shook his hand. Awesome. I lost my voice a little bit, so I'm sorry.
It was amazing.
See, you had a great time.
See the president, see the vice president.
Yes, sir.
See many black American conservatives.
So it was just lit. It was energy. This is our third, just me and her third time. So every time we go, President Trump, he's like so funny, and it's just lit. The energy is amazing every time. You feel warm.
Electrifying. Like, I caught chills. Susie came in, the way the crowd erupted in there was like...
The president said we blew his ears out.
Got a chance to listen to all the things that he's done for the black community, and I'm just grateful for this president. I didn't support him the last election, but after seeing what he's done and that speech he gave in there, he's convinced me I'm voting for him in 2020.
He made it very clear that he is here to put America first. You know, we have people suffering here, but meanwhile, we're spending so much time and energy devoted towards illegals or people coming to this country unfairly. And, you know, Democrats have made a mess of our inner cities, but he is really trying to root all that mess out and really help people in the ways that are actually effective, rather than the empty lies and promises that Democrats have been giving, but we haven't had any results.
People are waking up. People are changing. Humans are naturally conservative. Because we're humans. You grow up being taught to work hard for what you got. You don't grow up being told you're going to get something because you just want it. You're saying, like, you ain't got to work for it. When I went in the store and I tried to get a Snickers and I ain't had no money for it, mama smacked my hand, put that Snickers back. You feel me? We can't afford that. You know what I'm saying? But Democrats, they say, hey, we give you everything for free. That ain't reality. Because nothing is free because we pay for everything with our taxes. They work for us.
It was Donald Trump who woke me up, man. At first, when he was nominated and he was elected, I was not a big fan, but to see the things he's done for black community, to see things he's done for America in particular, I'm a huge fan now, and he has my support 4 more years, and I'll be voting for Donald J. Trump. And, see you there.
And when he told us, when he asked us, what the hell do we have to lose? I said, that is exactly right.
Right.
Our schools are horrible. Our communities are horrible.
We got to do something about
it. We have to do something about it.
And he is.
But I know with him, we're going to make a big change here in America.
I think a lot of African Americans are waking up and they're coming to the realization that Trump is great for America.
Trump has done so many fantastic things, not only for, you know, what you think the white people or the rich people, but for the black people, for the Asian people, for the Latino people, for everyone. He has done something amazing and he will keep doing things amazing. And when he is elected in 2020, he will continue to make this country better than it was before.
It's easy to get excited about a president who is putting your needs first. And that's too often something that we don't hear from the mainstream media, is the way he's trying to help America be the best that it can be. So it was fantastic to be there and, you know, just basically tell him thank you for standing up for us, because we know that he takes a lot of hits from the media for us, and we're so happy to support him.
You gotta love this man, man. He brings togetherness, man, and that's what it's about, unity as Americans, America first, man.
The media wants people to think that, you know, the black community hates Donald Trump, but that's not necessarily true. This event is proof, and I know you can say it's a small fraction of, you know, the black population, but they have family members and other people, friends who weren't able to come here, that they're ecstatic that they're here.
I don't think they're gonna show them. Because they want to, like, oh, Trump is racist. They're not going to show this because that's not a part of their narrative.
They're going to want to ignore it and hope it goes away. That's how they deal with, like, an inconvenient fact. They'll bury it, they'll ignore it, or they'll twist it.
Because they don't want to pretty much deal with the truth. And the fact of the matter is, the conservative message resonates with black America. And, you know, as time continues to turn, the Democrats are going to have to reckon with that eventually.
The little coverage that it seems that we do get in this movement is that we're paid, that we're tokens, that we're not actually believing in the voices that are speaking and
that we are being used and paid by politicians, and that's so, couldn't be so far from the truth. But that is how they like to paint us, specifically black conservatives. They like to deem us as tokens.
Instead of just telling the truth, it seems like they're so scared to tell the truth because they know, like, our community will wake up if they get the truth out there.
The media for a long time has fooled the black community into believing that Republicans are racist. But when we study our history, we find out that it was the Republicans that actually passed the first civil rights bill, and it was the Republicans that abolished slavery. And so now that we're starting to learn for ourselves and think for ourselves, you're going to see a lot of more black people voting for Republicans.
It's growing every day.
We see that on the ground every day. We see that on our social media every day. We interact with people every day that are waking up, that see this movement happening.
You have black conservatives not being scared to come out here and show who they are anymore, and you're going to have a revolution of young children out there in the future. They won't be so young anymore, and they're going to be speaking their mind, and they're going to be speaking the truth, and they're going to be proud of who they are. Conservatives, you can't shut them down. You can't shut them down on the social media, and they will always be who they are.
And we want all the smoke.
Yeah.
You did that. Because people like that, right? You think you can bully people to stop doing something, right? Call us coons, all them type of names, right? Usually people run into their little cubby holes after that. But I feel like it's a new movement now, and we want all the smoke. It's really clear. You feel me? Like Antifa, they keep bullying people because people allow themselves to get bullied. But see, the difference is we want all the smoke.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? People told me not to wear the MAGA hat, so I bought the biggest MAGA hat. Then I bought a bigger one. So next time somebody says something to me, duh, common sense, a bigger one. It's simple math, really, when you put it all together. So I feel like we started a new movement, and it's a revolution, and we want all the smoke. That's my message, period.